Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video I'm gonna show you why you should not use extension function to map your data layer model into domain layer model or vice versa. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So first you need a project. You can create your project by yourself, and in this project I'm gonna set up a very basic code base to show you the problem first, and after that we will discuss the solution for that. So in our mapper I'm gonna create here few packages like data layer, and corresponding to that we have domain layer. Now in this domain layer I'm gonna create two packages. So first is for model and second is for our repository. So now in this model I'm gonna create a data class, and the data class name is login. We have few parameters in here like first name, type of this thing is string. Next we have last name, type of this thing is string. Lastly we have age, type is int, and password, type of this thing is also string. So this is my domain layer model. Now it's time to create a repository. This is an interface, and name of this thing is auth repository that contain a function, and the function name is login. Simply pass your domain layer model, which is login, and the return type of this function is result, and type of this thing is string. So now it's time to write implementation for our authentication repository. So for that, go to your data layer and create here your data layer model and its repository. So here in this model, I'm gonna create a data class. So this will eventually become my data layer model, login DTO. It has two things. First, it has email and password. Type of this thing is again string. Now in this repository we have a class auth repo impl. This class will give the implementation for our authentication repository, control I and override login function. In this, first we have to write a extension function to map our domain layer model into data layer model. So let's do that. In this data we have a package, and the package name is mappers, and in this mapper we have a file, and the file name is mapper ext. So I'm going to create an extension over login to DTO. A return type of this function is login DTO, return login DTO. And in this, we have to create first our email, left the password. So password is coming natively from login, so use it. Now it's time to construct our email. So for that, I'm using the first name, lowercase it, and add this thing with our last name, lowercase it. Also, I'm gonna use my age, and also I'm going to add one suffix, which is @gmail.com. So this is my email. So simply use it over here. So the sole purpose of this extension function is to map login into a login DTO, or you can say domain model into data layer model. So now it's time to use it. Go to your authentication repository implementation. So first I'm gonna create here try catch, because sometimes it may throw an exception. So once it throw an exception, I'm gonna use a result.failure, and it I'm gonna pass the exception. So first let's transform the login into login DTO. So login DTO, login dot to DTO. So now we do have our login DTO. It's time to check few cases. So if our login DTO email contains @gmail.com, then only we will proceed. So result.success, and here I'm gonna simply pass success, else I'm gonna throw an exception, and message of this exception is error. Simply use here a return keyword in front of try. So this is my login function, and I want to write a unit test case that will test the error case, I mean this case. So let's see how we can write it. So for that, open up your example unit test, and here let's begin with our unit test case. So function should not proceed with wrong email. So first in this function, I'm gonna create my authentication repository. So auth repository implementation. Next we have our login. So in this login we have to pass our first name, so let's use my name. In its last name, I'm using my last name. Age is 24 and password is some gibberish. Okay, now I'm going to simply create a result variable that holds my result. So auth repository dot login, and simply pass login in here, and at the end I'm gonna assert. So I want to write a test case that is verifying my error logic in the auth repository implementation. So that must give me a message of error, because this message is coming from our exceptions. So result dot exception or null message. Just try to execute it. Okay, so our test case fails and the problem is expectation is error, but we are receiving null. Why it is happening? In this extension function, we have put all of our code logic that do the transformation thing. And we cannot mock those things because extension function are static method. You cannot mock it. So due to that reason, you are not able to test this error case. And this is the problem. Our logic is coupled in this extension function that we cannot mock. So now it's time to see the solution for this problem. Because if you are using extension function, let's say you are working on a big project that contains 300 or 400 model classes. So you have to write 300, 400 extension function that will do the mapping things. But here, all of your logic will be scattered everywhere in your project, and this is a very bad practice. So don't use extension function to map your domain layer model into data layer or vice versa. Now I'm going to show you the approach through which you can write the test case which will verify the error case. So for that, in the mapper, I'm going to create a interface, and the interface name is mapper. Now this is a generic interface, so I want to perform the transformation from type F to type T. In this, we have a function and the function name is map. So I want to perform transformation from type F to type T. Okay, so now let's write a mapper class that will do the transformation. So class login to login DTO mapper. Use your mapper. So I want to perform transformation from login to login DTO. All of our logic is present in our extension. So copy this thing from here, come back to your mapper and simply press Ctrl I to override map. Now paste in here. So we are receiving login and the name of that thing is from. So use here from. So from dot first name, copy this thing up, paste in here, similarly in here and in the password too. Now this will do the transformation. It's time to use it. So for that, go to your authentication repository interface and create one more function over here. And the name of this time function is login mapper. Go to your authentication repository implementation, simply press Ctrl I and override it. Rest of the things are pretty much same. So copy this stuff, paste in here. Instead of using this extension, now you can use your mapper. So for that, I'm gonna pass here my mapper, and the type of this mapper is login to login DTO mapper, and initially its value is null. So let's use it over here, and I'm sure this will never null in here. Use map and pass your login that you are receiving from this function. Now it will do the transformation and rest of the logic is pretty much same. Now you are able to write a test case which will verify your error case, basically this one. So let's see how we can do that. So go to your example unit test, and here I'm gonna create one more test case, and the name of this test case is should not proceed with wrong email, and I'm gonna extend this thing with mapper so that it will create some differentiator. Cool. So first I'm gonna create my mapper. So this is a mock object. Now you can mock it because it's a class. But if you are using extension function, you cannot mock it. And the type of this thing would be login to login DTO mapper. It's time to create our authentication repository. So auth repo implementation, and in its mapper, you can pass your mapper that you have been just created on the top. Okay, so now I'm gonna use here whenever. This will create few scenarios that you want to test in your authentication repository implementation that depends on your mapper logic. So when our mapper calls the map function, and in its map we have to pass login. So let's create login, or instead of creating this login, you can simply copy this thing from here. So paste in here. So when our mapper.map call with this login, then you can return what? You can return a login DTO. And in its email, you can pass empty string. In its password, you can pass empty string. Now you can create some specific scenarios based on the mapper class. Okay, so it's time to assert the changes, but before that let me grab the result from my authentication repository. So auth repository dot login mapper, and here you can pass your login. So I'm expecting error because email is empty and this is not satisfying our condition. So use your result exception or null and simply grab its message. So now we do have a test case that will verify our authentication repository implementation should not proceed with wrong email. So let's execute it. And here you can see this time our test case passes successfully, and also we can mock the error behavior. Now let's see if I add in here, let's say @gmail.com and execute it, surely it fails. Yes, it failed because here you can see assertion is error. Basically, I'm expecting error, but this value is coming null. This is a problem. And this has happened because this time our login DTO contains an email that contains @gmail.com. So by using this approach, you can write your mapper classes. And this is very important for big project because in big project, you have a lot of data classes. And if you want to perform mapping with extension function, it will automatically increase your headache because you are not able to find extension function very easily. You have to do a lot of manual hard work to find an exact extension function that will do the same task. But with classes, it's very easy. And also all of your logic will be encapsulated in a single class, which is a very good practice. Now we are going to see how we can perform complex transformation. Like if you want to convert a list of type F to list of type T, how you can perform such type of transformation. So for that, I'm going to create here an extension function over mapper, which is a generic one. Function F to T. So this is an extension function over mapper. So F to type T. And I'm going to call this map all. So pass your list. Type of this thing is list of F, and I want to perform transformation. So use your list map, and this contain a map. So this is a map that we have been created in our mapper interface. Simply pass your it in it. So it will do the transformation. So by using this approach, you can create generalized mapper extension function that you can use through your transformation. So it's very easy for you. And also these are the generalized functions. So all of your other classes that are using these steps, they are very generalized. I mean, in your whole project, your mapper is now generalized. They have a same structure. Only the things changes in their implementation is type F to T. So that's all. This is all for this video. I hope you like this video. It's a very crucial video if you are working on a big project, because in big projects they are using these approaches. If you like this video, subscribe my channel and also write your comments. And if you want to give some suggestion, you can write your suggestion in the comment box. We'll meet in our next video where we'll discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.